In this video, we will examine 5 factors that can impair your sleep. If you are interested in this topic, we advise to check out our previous video about the top 7 foods to eat before bed. The first thing impairing your sleep is light. Light helps regulate the human biological clock, notably through melatonin, a hormone that signals your body that it's time to sleep. Blue light, which is produced by the sun, also present in the screens of TV sets, computers, and even smartphones, disrupts your production of melatonin. A small randomized crossover trial examining the impact of smartphones with and without blue light found that even though smartphones with blue light didn't significantly affect serum melatonin levels, they still reduced sleepiness. So if you have to use electronics before bedtime, consider installing a program that gradually reduces blue light from the screen after sunset. Fortunately, more and more devices come with such a program pre-installed, like the night shift on iPhones and Macs. If this feature is not available to you, or if the blue light source is a lighting fixture in a room you share with other people, consider wearing blue light blocking glasses a couple of hours before bedtime. Finally, if you live in an area where light pollution is a concern, consider installing blackout curtains or using a sleep mask. Now, let's talk about noise. As we've just seen, lights that don't keep you awake can still impair the quality of your sleep. Similarly, sounds that don't wake you up can still increase stress and impair the quality of your sleep. Not all sounds will have the same impact, however. Sudden noises are more likely to disturb your sleep than constant noises. Moreover, the noises most likely to disturb your sleep are those that carry meaning. At equal volume, two people talking are more likely to wake you up than instrumental music, and you might be able to sleep through heavy traffic noise yet awaken with a start if your baby makes a much softer but disquieting sound. So if you must sleep in a noisy environment and are not a parent, consider getting earplugs. Keep in mind, however, that earplugs attenuate high frequencies more than they do low frequencies, meaning that they may protect you against cars honking, but not much against traffic rumble. The third factor is heat. Some studies show that elevated core body temperature has been associated with insomnia. Thus, if your bedroom is too warm, you may have trouble falling asleep and are likely to experience a decrease in the quality of your sleep. On the other hand, reductions in core body temperature have been associated with reductions in sleep latency. Thus, if your bedroom is cool, but not so chilly as to be uncomfortable, you may fall asleep faster and enter the deeper stages of sleep sooner. Even if high temperatures don't prevent you from falling asleep, you should still strive to sleep in a cool room, for heat can impair sleep quality more than noise does. The next factor is alcohol. Alcohol is a depressant of the central nervous system. In other words, alcohol helps you unwind, and you may think it helps you sleep better. The research, however, shows otherwise. Yes, at first, alcohol can help you fall asleep, but this effect fades off after a few days if you keep drinking close to bedtime. And right from the start, it will impair the quality of your sleep. Ironically, alcohol use disorders have even been linked to insomnia, though their being cause or consequence is uncertain. Before we reveal the last factor, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're curious about science applied to health issues, and hit that bell icon so you receive the notifications every time we upload a new video. Last but not least is caffeine. Caffeine is usually safe and it has its benefits, but not for the quality of your sleep. Caffeine can block different adenosine receptors in the brain, with varying effects. By blocking the A1 receptor, which promotes sleepiness when activated, caffeine can increase alertness. By blocking the A2A receptor, caffeine can increase dopamine levels, with stimulating and mood-enhancing effects. The A1 receptor doesn't seem to get desensitized, which may be why caffeine doesn't lose its awakening effect. However, the A2A receptor does get desensitized, which is why coffee veterans don't feel true stimulation even after drinking several cups, and why some people choose to cycle caffeine. It's true, many people can fall asleep with caffeine coursing their veins. Yet even as they slumber, caffeine makes them more alert and their sleep more shallow. For that reason, caffeine should be avoided within the 6 hours before bedtime. In summary, to protect your sleep, avoid alcohol after dinner and caffeine during the 6 hours before bedtime. You should also avoid bright lights and blue lights during the 2 hours before bedtime, and as much as possible, shun all light and noise while you sleep. Finally, you'll sleep better in a cool place.
This video is our interpretation of scientific papers. It is merely informative and doesn't constitute any form of advice. If you have any health issues or concerns, please contact your physician or licensed health professional.